they're just starting to bloom up. Some very nice asters, particularly one, the white woodland aster, is just starting to bloom. And the big leaf aster, which both of these will grow in very sandy soils because I live 60 miles east of here, and I have wonderful sandy soils too. You also have some Cuper, there's American elm root, Cuper Americana, and my favorite, the maple leaf elm root, Cuper Velosa, variety Apocyphorea. Why is the variety Apocyphorea? It has beautiful purple cream leaves, surprisingly large white flowers that's blooming its head off right now. You don't think of a lot of plants in the woodland blooming in August, but this is a real standard. You also have some very good goldenrod still waiting in the field. And finally, fire pink, Pyrene.
All right, there you have it. Thank you, Karen, for calling. Appreciate your call. Let's turn to Jane in Sedonia. Hi, Jane.
Hi. We're spreading out some pine trees into an alfalfa field, and we don't necessarily want this to be a lawn area. Would you have any suggestions for us?
So when you say you're putting pines into a field, is it alfalfa is there now, is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, and you want to have what kind of growing situation? You want to have like a low maintenance turf or like a low growing grass or something like that?
A no mow or something?
Yeah, I heard something about no mow, or you mow it like four times a year or something.
Dude, that's a lot.
You don't have to mow again.
Yeah, what you might want to look at, Karen, is our normal lawn mix, which is a combination of six different pine zesters, which are adapted to well-drained soils. They do not grow on really heavy clay or damp soils.
This is pretty heavy clay.
Pretty heavy clay. Do you have at least 4 inches of good black top soil over that clay?
No, it's pretty much clay.
Pretty much clay. That's going to be a problem. The normal really likes good drainage and a fairly loose soil. Heavy clay is not the best situation, especially during drought. It needs to get its roots down into the soil. It doesn't penetrate the clay very well, so when you get a hot, dry summer, you might not have some plants that will go dormant and won't look as good. So,
I mean, they have, like, I've got these couple, like, fruit trees, you know, cherry trees that and then he's got the right idea that he's going to plant some cedar trees for kind of,
okay, I have a couple more questions for you. The base clay, correct?
Somewhere here, yeah.
Okay, and how much sand, black dirt, et cetera, was placed on top of that clay?
In the area of yard that we're talking about,
yeah.
At least, I don't know, a couple dump trucks.
Okay, how did it...